friends. Today in our class we are going to study and understand about changes in caste system in post-independent period. It can be discussed under two headings: functional changes in caste system and changes in the role of caste system. First we understand functional changes in caste system. The caste system was neither disintegrated nor has it disappeared in present India. Despite many modifications during last 6 decades, the caste structures have considerably changed. Two important features: hereditary membership and hierarchy have not changed at all. But we do find some changes in the following. The first one, occupational choice is relaxed. Means earlier the occupations come from hereditary. Now the occupational choice is relaxed. One can choose the occupation on his choice. And the second point is decline and disappearance of caste panchayats. Because of British government make legislations laws. So, the third point is commensal restriction or relaxed. The fourth in the religious basis of caste has cramped. Caste is no more believed to be divinely ordained. Though occupational choices and rules relating to marriage are relaxed, social status continues to be dependent on one's caste membership. So these are the functional changes in caste system. And the second point is the changes in the role of caste system. The major changes in the role of caste system are election based on caste system. In modern India, it is very important and every political party is aware of its vote catching power. Even though the political leaders are condemned caste in public, in practice caste considerations are potent. The second point is increase of caste consciousness and organization. Because of the caste consciousness and organization has increased in modern India, caste-based educational institutions like banks, hostels, cooperative societies, charities, marriage halls and generals are the indicators of caste consciousness. The generals published by the caste organization are the main units of the media of communicate integration. It means we can say that the community aspect of caste has been made more comprehensive and permanent. It become increased caste consciousness. So, the third is the impact of modern means of transport and communication. We can say in words, we can understand it better in words of M.N. Srinivas. He says, so, the building of roads all are over India. And the introduction of railway, postal service, cheap paper and printing, especially in regional languages, has enabled caste to organize as they had never done before. The availability of cheap newsprint has facilitated the founding of caste generals, whose aim is to promote the interest of their respective castes. The fourth point is impact of modern education. No doubt modern education youth being inspired by the ideals of equality, liberty, fraternity, scientific outlook, secularism. These all have changed the attitude toward caste system. It does not necessarily mean that caste has disappeared. Funds were collected to organize the caste meetings to help the poor members. All these help to change caste system, the way of thinking of people. So these are the important points of we can study in post-independent period, how the caste system changed. Thanks for listening.